Capital punishment in Delaware was abolished after being declared unconstitutional by the Delaware Supreme Court on August 2, 2016. The ruling retroactively applies to earlier death sentences. Despite this, the capital statute for first-degree murder under Title 11, Chapter 42, Section 09, of the Delaware Code has yet to be repealed, though it is unenforceable. Prior to this, it had the third highest number of executions per capita, behind Oklahoma and Texas. 16 people were executed in the state after the Gregg versus Georgia decision of 1976. The last person executed in the state was 28-year-old Shannon Johnson, who was executed on April 20, 2012. Delaware was one of the four states, along with Alabama, Florida, and Indiana, where the judge may override a jury decision. The statute was struck down in 2016 because the judge decided not only the sentence itself, but also some factual findings necessary to make the defendant eligible for capital punishment. The governor was allowed to grant a commutation of the death sentence, but only after receiving a recommendation of clemency from a board or advisory group. The only post-Furman pardon was granted by Governor Jack Markell on January 17, 2012. It was the first time the board had recommended a death sentence to be commuted. Since the reinstatement of capital punishment in 1974, the last man hanged in Delaware was Billy Bailey, at the time of his execution. Delaware had not carried out a hanging for 50 years, so sought advice from corrections officials at Walla Walla State Penitentiary in Washington, the only other state that has carried out any hangings. Lastly, the wooden gallows had been built in the grounds of the Delaware Correctional Center at Smyrna in 1986, as Bailey's first execution date approached. The structure required renovation and strengthening before Bailey could be executed on it. The platform housing the trapdoor is 15 feet from the ground and is accessed by 23 steps. Delaware used an execution protocol written by Fred Leuchter. This specifies the use of 30 feet of 3 to 4 inch diameter Manila hemp rope, boiled to take out stretch and any tendency to coil. The area of the rope sliding inside the knot was lubricated with melted paraffin wax to allow it to slide freely. A black hood is specified by the protocol, as is a sandbag to test the trap door and a collapse board, to which a prisoner can be strapped if necessary. Although the method of execution in Delaware had been changed to lethal injection, Billy Bailey had the legal option of choosing to be hanged instead. Bailey refused to accept lethal injection, telling a visitor, "I'm not going to let them put me to sleep." Billy Bailey was born in 1947. He became the third person to be hanged in America since the resumption of executions in 1977. Bailey was assigned to the Plummer House, a work release facility in Wilmington, Delaware. However, Bailey escaped, later appearing at the home of his foster sister, Sue Ann Coker, in Schwold, Delaware, saying he was upset and was not going back to the Plummer House. He and Charles Coker, his foster sister's husband, went on an errand in Coker's truck. Bailey asked Coker to stop at a package store. Bailey entered the store and robbed the clerk at gunpoint. Emerging from the store with a pistol in one hand and a bottle in the other, Bailey told Coker that the police would be arriving and asked to be dropped at Lambertson's Corner. about 1.5 miles away. At Lambertson's Corner, Bailey entered the farmhouse of Gilbert Lambertson, aged 80, and his wife, Claire Lambertson, aged 73. Bailey shot Gilbert Lambertson twice in the chest with a pistol and once in the head with the Lambertson's shotgun. He also shot Claire Lambertson once in the shoulder with the pistol and once in the abdomen and once in the neck with the shotgun. Both Lambertsons died. Bailey arranged their bodies in chairs and then fled from the scene. He was spotted by a Delaware State Police helicopter as he ran across the Lambertson's field. He attempted to shoot the helicopter co-pilot with the pistol and was later arrested. Bailey was found guilty of the murders in 1980. After his conviction, the jury held that the crimes were outrageously or wantonly vile, horrible, or inhuman and recommended the death penalty. Bailey was moved from his prison cell to a caravan close to the gallows in preparation for the execution, where he spent his last 24 hours sleeping, eating, watching television, talking with staff and meeting with his sister Betty Odom, the prison chaplain, and his attorney. After his appeals failed, Bailey was executed by the state of Delaware on January 25, 1996. He refused to exercise his option to choose lethal injection as a method of execution and was instead hanged. He became the third person to be hanged in the United States since the 1976 Supreme Court decision Gregg v. Georgia allowed executions, halted in 1967, to resume. A few minutes before midnight, Bailey was led into the yard, which was surrounded by prison guards with dogs. His glasses had been removed. He was wearing a prison-ish blue denim coat draped over his shoulders, the top two buttons fastened to keep it from blowing off in the wind. His arms were fastened at his sides. For his last meal, he had requested a well-done steak, a baked potato with sour cream and butter, buttered rolls, peas and vanilla ice cream. As is customary, a direct telephone line to the governor of Delaware was kept open up to the last minute in case of clemency. Two guards wearing black jumpsuits and black hoods held in place by baseball caps escorted Bailey, who weighed 220 pounds, up the steps to the gallows platform, where he stood with the six-coil noose swaying in the night breeze beside him until the 40 or so witnesses had entered the compound. He stood flanked by the guards for nearly 5 minutes. One faced forward, holding Bailey's left arm. The other kept his back to witnesses and held the prisoner's shoulder. Warden Robert Snyder, who was to be the hangman, was standing further to the right. When the witnesses were in position, Bailey was led onto the trap. A nylon webbing strap was placed around his ankles and a black hood pulled down over his head and upper chest. The noose was placed over the hood. Several times Snyder felt at the hood to be certain that the knot was correctly positioned beneath Bailey's left ear. Bailey stood calmly on the trap and was seen to squeeze his right fist into a tight ball. A moment later, at 12:04 a.m., on January 25, 1996, Warden Snyder, holding the gray wooden lever with both hands, released the trap door, which opened with a loud bang. 5 feet of manila rope followed Bailey through the hole and his body jerked to a halt 10 feet above the ground. Bailey's body spun counterclockwise 6 times, then rotated once in the opposite direction. A canvas tarpaulin was now released to conceal the body, just his dangling feet in white tennis shoes remaining visible. He was pronounced dead 11 minutes later, at 12:15 a.m. Eastern Standard Time by the doctor. He was 49 years at the time of his execution. Thank you for watching Death Row.